This is the day we celebrate our Savior's birth. Let us give thanks and praise Him for all He has done for us and the hope that we have. Now read scripture taken from Luke 2, 1 to 5. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And that tax was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, because she was great with the child. And then the second reading is from 2 Thessalonians 2, verses 16 and 17. May our Lord Jesus Christ Himself and God our Father, who has loved us and given us everlasting comfort and hope, which we don't deserve, comfort your hearts with all comfort and help you in every good thing you say and do. And then the little verse that I have, Christmas is different this year. Not the happiness we usually have. Things are changing, and we must turn our thoughts and hearts to God. May the peace of God be with each one of us for now and the days to come. May the hope that comes from God give us His peace and contentment. This is my time special for our Lord Jesus Christ was born on this day. Christ, our Savior, was born. I wish you all a good Christmas and God's blessing to each one. We thank you.
Little boy spoke the world into place. Almighty came down and walked among men. The wonder of wonders, he died for my sin. The wonder of wonders, he died for my sin.
If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to everyone liberally and without reproach, and it shall be given. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication. With thanksgiving, let your requests be made unto God, and with the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world.
And in closing in this, I'd like to wish everyone a great holiday, Merry Christmas, and definitely peace on earth.
Where Psalm 16:8-11. I keep my eyes always on the Lord. With him at my right hand, I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad and my tongue rejoices. My body also will rest secure. Because you will not abandon me to the realm of the dead, nor will you let your faithful one see decay. You make known to me the path of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence, with eternal pleasures at your right hand.
Luke 2:8-14. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward all." At times during 2020, happiness has seemed elusive. It's been a tough and trying year for everyone. None of what has happened to any of us this year is unknown by God. None of our loss, our frustration, our anger, our grief, or our depression goes unseen by the one who created us, knows us, and loves us even still. But joy is not mere happiness. Joy is an extreme happiness that cannot be overcome by circumstances. Joy is a fruit of the Spirit, and it is deep in our souls. Even when we cannot see those we love the most, even when we worry about where the next paycheck is coming from, even when we grieve for the divisions that are so apparent in our society today, we can be joyful because we know that Christ has come and he is coming again.
This matters because while in 2020, as we await the end of a dreadful pandemic and we long for Christ to come again, we don't have to despair. No one and nothing can take away the joy God has given us. This year, lighting this candle is truly a prayer for God's light to shine into the darkness. This Christmas, our prayer for you and for ourselves is that we may all experience the eager anticipation of wonderful things to come and the promised joy of Christ Emmanuel. He is with us. No one and nothing can take him away from us. Run to him and feel joy, just as the shepherds felt joy as they ran to Bethlehem to see their long-awaited king.
Thank you. Good evening, Onaway Baptist Church. We are the Keeson family. We are extremely honored and blessed to be asked to be doing this tonight. We will be lighting the love candle and reading two scripture readings.
I will be reading Luke 2:15-20. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
I will be reading John 3:16-17. God loved the world so much that he gave his one and only Son. Anyone who believes in him will not die, but will have eternal life. God did not send his Son into the world to judge the world. He sent his Son to save the world through him.
The whole meaning of Christmas can be explained in one word: love. God sent his gift of pure love to us that first Christmas. God loved us. He still loves us. He wanted to have a relationship with us, to walk with us like he did with Adam and Eve in the garden. So, with the ultimate expression of love, he sent Jesus. Jesus, who was fully God, made himself small and vulnerable and one of us to show us the way. This is the true meaning of Christmas. Christmas isn't about presents under the tree or decorations or lights all over houses. It is a day that we think about the great plan that God had to restore us into relationship with him. He came because he loves us all. We are so incredibly thankful for the love of God. Love isn't just what God does and gives, it's who he is. The Bible has a lot to say about his love. You can read all about it. But being blessed to experience his love and grace for yourself is absolutely amazing. It fills your heart up with so much happiness, peace, and joy. It fills your heart with love, with God's love. He sees you. He sees what's in your heart, and he loves you. He loves us all. Most of you know that our family has had some hard times this year, and God heard my husband's prayers. God heard my prayers. Our family has felt his love pour out from above and through all of you, our friends, our church family. We are so appreciative and forever grateful for your love, for God's love. Our family has seen and felt the love of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And we will never forget that God didn't abandon us. He wept when we cried. He carried us when we felt tired and scared. We have witnessed his love firsthand, and it is incredible. It is everlasting. The Lord is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger, and rich in love. From our family to yours,
Merry Christmas!
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed. The little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the cattle are lowing, the baby awakes, but little Lord Jesus, no crying he makes. I love thee, Lord Jesus, look down from the sky, and stay by my cradle till morning. I ask thee to thy tender care, and take us to heaven to live with thee there.
Merry Christmas!